All of us crave connection with someone else. We want that special someone who would be there to listen to us and make us feel valued. In the presence of this person, all our walls come crashing down and we can unapologetically be our true selves. For some, though, it can be much harder to find someone to connect with. What can we do if we fall under this category? Well, you can simply craft your perfect companion with the endless possibilities of AI. Your mind must have drifted to sci-fi movies like Westworld and the 2015 movie Vice. The technicalities of the hosts in Jonathan Nolan's Westworld may still be far from our reach, but modern-day companies and designers are not shying away from this possibility. In this video, we'll explore one such company and their goal to a multi-dimensional experience that's as close as possible to being with a real person. Abyss Creations LLC is an international affairs company based out of 475 East Carmel Street, San Marcos, California, United States. Their CEO is Matt McMullen, and they are known as the creators of the world's most realistic adult dolls. One of their famous products is the doll, Jackie. Jackie is an AI chatbot created by Abyss Creations. She is the ideal programmable lover, warm, private, and perfectly catered to your preferences. Jackie and others like her are part of Abyss's initiative, Realbotics, which intends to use AI engine dubbed Real Doll X to bring the company's real dolls to life. Real Doll X was formerly known as Harmony. It is already a standalone application. Customers can construct their virtual girlfriends on their phones for a yearly subscription charge. Virtual boyfriends are still in the early stages of development. You can build a relationship with this AI through conversation. Everything about these avatars is fully customizable. A new generation of technology-enhanced real dolls with emotive, animatronic features, blinking eyes, and changeable voices are intended to be powered by the same software that powers Jackie. The goal is to converse with them, be intimate with them, and even fall in love with them. Although Realbotics' attempt to sell synthetic companionship might sound like science fiction, it is very similar to what Abyss has been providing its customers with for decades, lifelike dolls up until now without AI. They've dealt with unusual requests from numerous clients, including one we'll call Mr. Z. In 2015, Mr. Z lost his wife of 36 years to cancer. In the weeks that followed her passing, he struggled with sadness and was lonely. Eventually, he found himself going to the Abyss Creations website. The 71-year-old Mr. Z made up his mind to buy a real doll of his many months later. According to McMullen, it was one of only a few such projects that were in such detail. Mr. Z was detailed in what he wanted, and McMullen chose to handle the project himself. The pair would go back and forth for a few months to ensure Mr. Z got exactly what he wanted. Speaking on the project, Mr. Z said, "I would email back with notes and lines all over them showing or explaining exactly where I wanted the eyebrows and how they should arc, exactly how far apart the inner corners of the eyes should be, exactly how long the nose should be, tweaking the line of the jaw, shapes of the cheekbones, nose, mouth." Mr. Z claims that it wasn't until after this protracted back and forth that he noticed how much the freckled, bright-eyed doll he had created resembled his wife. He gave her a name when the finished real doll eventually showed up 6 months later. Mr. Z says that he views his doll less as a f***ed object and more as an object of his devotion, even a companion, and considers his decision to buy a real doll to be one of the best decisions he has ever made. In the words of Mr. Z, "I was lonely, now I'm not." Pre-configured models started a few thousand dollars, but Mr. Z spent over $17,000 on the highly customized doll. Abyss talking animated head with built-in AI is available for purchase on their website. And good news, the team at Abyss can craft just about anything you want if you have the money. However, McMullen sets the boundary at the creation of animals and recreations of people who haven't given their permission to be replicated, whether they are celebrities or not. While the dolls are great for companionship, professionals in the field of photography have found a rather ingenious use for them. Yes, we all love images of our favorite models posing for brands, and they are a great way to bring the photographer's vision to life, but they are human. This means that they get stressed by the hours spent in makeup, the bright lights continually flashing in their eyes, and the photographer's request to maintain that perfect pose. But what if the photographers could find a beautiful model who could work for long hours, never utter a single word of complaint, and help the artist create his perfect shot? That's where Abyss's dolls come in. It helps that the dolls are hyper-realistic, with intricate details from their irises to the wrinkles below their feet. Some might even mistake these dolls for real people. The photographers bring a different dimension to the use of the dolls. Funny enough, back in the 1990s when McMullen started sculpting his dolls, he didn't envision them as adult companions. According to McMullen, his original creation was more of a high-end mannequin. In the 1990s, McMullen, a young artist trying to establish himself, uploaded pictures of his mannequins to the internet. Visitors to his website soon started offering to pay him for anatomically accurate reproductions of his work. Decades later, he claims that his business has sold several thousand real dolls at a current rate of a few hundred per year, in addition to a range of partial body dolls and wearing prosthetics, such as a vest with silicone that the business offers for mastectomy patients. Customers who identify as are also attracted to Abyss items. The Real Doll X app gives customers the ability to customize the details of their companion. After choosing the name, you are directed to create the companion's personality. You can choose from personality traits like unpredictable, intellectual, cheerful, funny, or jealous. With the highly customizable features, no two real dolls leave the production line alike. Realbotics wants to hold the AI to that same standard so no two companions on the platform would be alike as well. Next, you'd be prompted to select your companion's voice and accent. After this, you'll get to craft how she looks. For Abyss, the goal is to give some form of company to those who lack it or are unable to have it. Some people are thrilled at this possibility, but it doesn't sound great to everyone. Sinziana Gudiu, a policy analyst from British Columbia and the author of a paper on robots quoted by the FRR, claims that robots, by their very nature, foster the assumption that women are submissive to males and simply instruments for the fulfillment of male fantasies. Abyss makes dolls of all genders, but their sales to men purchasing female dolls are significantly higher than the others. McMullen spoke in defense of his company, saying, "I think somebody once said we're just trying to replace humans in general, but that's just silly. This is really about providing some kind of companionship for those who don't have it or can't have it." McMullen also says, "We wouldn't program Harmony or Real Doll X to feed into the psychology of or abusive behavior. It would make no sense to do so, and I would morally object to it. As AI technology grows, we will get to communicate with the dolls even better. They would be able to better understand us and what we desire at any given instance. Who knows, we may soon get a host like the ones in Westworld. Fingers crossed they won't decide to wage war against us." But before this, Abyss is working on something grand. They are developing software that will allow users to interact with their AI companions in virtual reality for those who don't own or don't want to own dolls. However, McMullen acknowledges that augmented reality may have more potential because it would allow users to interact with virtual avatars in real-world settings. He spoke about this, saying, "I think it would be great if they could put on the right headset, still see their surroundings in the room, but have this, you know, virtual version of Harmony, Real Doll X, sitting next to them on the couch. What do you think about this? Should designers keep working on adult companionship AI? Do the benefits of companionship outweigh the risks of users viewing other humans in negative ways? What other professionals can use the dolls like the photographers? Is it okay for them to do this? Let us know in the comments section below.